and thanks for joining us from our studios in Israel. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh here with ILTV's Morning Briefing.
A joint task force of various Israeli security forces came together last night to put an end to a covert weapons manufacturing workshop in the West Bank. The IDF, Shin Bet, border police, and Israeli police made this discovery in the Palestinian village of Al-Ram, just outside of Jerusalem. For years, Palestinian terrorists have been using the homemade Carlo submachine gun for shooting attacks on Israeli civilians and soldiers. It's not a very accurate weapon, but it's enough to kill people, and it's cheap and easy to produce with some basic equipment. The security forces confiscated the two labs they found in the site, as well as numerous weapons. In a separate operation, the IDF mapped out the house of a terrorist who was involved in the recent Damascus Gate terror attack, which killed an Israeli border police woman. This is the first step in the upcoming demolition of his home. Tuesday's UNESCO resolution attacking Israeli presence in the Old City of Jerusalem may have angered the Israeli foreign minister, but the Palestinian Authority and Hamas are both quite pleased. A Hamas spokesman is saying that the resolution demolishes the false Israeli narrative, and that it's time to take action to save Jerusalem and Al-Aqsa Mosque from Judaization, excavation, and Zionist projects. A spokesman from the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas Fatah movement is on the same page, saying that the resolution is historic justice and reflects the Palestinian position of rejecting recognizing Jerusalem as the capital of the occupation. The Israeli foreign minister is denouncing the resolution as another bizarre and irrelevant decision that won't change the reality of the city's status as Israel's capital. The foreign ministry says that the UNESCO action is, quote, sad, unnecessary, and pathetic. A U.S. Navy aircraft carrier has been docked off the coast of Haifa in northern Israel this week. And a top IDF officer is saying that it's a sign of deepening strategic ties between the U.S. and Israel. The USS George H.W. Bush has been a major part of the American campaign against the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. And the nuclear-powered ship's capabilities are pretty amazing. It can carry a crew of over 5,000 sailors, as well as around 90 fighter jets and helicopters. Lieutenant Colonel Yaniv Kapach, head of the Northern American branch in the IDF's planning directorate, says that the U.S. and Israel have increased their joint exercises lately and are, quote, developing more and more exercises that we can do together in different ways. He says that Israel's understanding in the region is, quote, very deep and to some extent unique, and that the U.S. has a lot to gain from Israeli knowledge. Following the new daycare guidelines, multi-age daycare centers are limited to no more than 2 children under 1 year of age, leaving a shortage of private daycare options for Israeli parents with infant children. In an attempt to find a solution for Israeli parents, Knesset member Yaakov Asher is now turning to Welfare Minister Chaim Katz, stating that the, quote, new guidelines severely harm Haredi communities where the number of young babies needing a private daycare center is higher than the number of older children. Reportedly, Katz states that the welfare ministry is building new daycare centers all over the country, which cost 350 million shekels. The law currently allows all different kinds of daycare centers to accept up to 6 babies under the age of 1, but the 7th baby requires an additional staff member. Hopefully, these issues will be solved and ready for action by the start of next school year. Ready for the largest concert in Israel ever? Well, the Guns N' Roses are going to be live in Tel Aviv later this month for their sold-out performance. But after selling 61,900 tickets, more tickets than any other show in Israel, the promoter Guy Bessel of Bluestone Group warned the public on Wednesday to be wary of fake tickets. According to a statement by Bessel, some reports of fake tickets have already been made. He warns the public to stick to Ticketmaster only, adding that international sites and even Facebook was no good. The hard rock band that formed in 1985 have sold over 100 million records, making them ultimately one of the best-selling bands in history. And the show in Tel Aviv will be the final concert of the band's European tour, not in this lifetime. This isn't the first time Guns N' Roses visited Israel. Back in May 1993, the rock band came to Israel as part of their 2-year world tour of their twin albums, Use Your Illusion 1 and 2. during that two-year tour is when the group started having issues with drug and alcohol abuse, but you know, 20 years later, thankfully everyone's back on track and rocking and rolling.
That's all for now. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh, and see you later with our main daily broadcast from Israel at 2 p.m. Eastern Time.